Today, I will talk about wood-derived biocomposites, flexible electronics, and energy device from micro to nanoscale. As we can see, for a long time, the abundant use of plastic products from petroleum resources causes serious light pollution and energy exhaustions. We are increasingly convinced that an environmental and energy crisis is coming. It is urgent to devote us to explore biodegradable, renewable materials and clean energy such as biomass materials, wind energy, solar energy, and other clean energy. Countless plastic products can be seen everywhere in our life. They are non-renewable and non-biodegradable, which brings huge challenges to us. However, it also gives possible opportunity for the renewable agroforestry biomass of such starch, straw, reed, and wood. And especially large that wood is one of the most abundant resources on Earth. With 3 trillion trees life around the world, equal to 420 trees per person, is a renewable and biodegradable. So, converting the biomass wood into usable biocomposite materials to replace part of the plastic products will provide a scientific solution to alleviate the environmental pollution. So, I believe that we as researchers need more responsibility and efforts to do valuable works to alleviate the current energy and environmental crisis, to propose some more sustainable development paths for a green world in future. As we can know, there are obvious difference in struggles between natural wood and the typical plastics, concretes, metals. In a sense, wood resource is really advanced by composites with porous trachytes in structure, surrounded by a cell and is composed of cellulose, semi-cellulose, and lignin. Compared to plastic, metal, concrete, wood has attractive properties of hierarchic purpose, the porous structure, multiscale fibrous structure, composite nanostructure, biodegradable and renewable. However, we can also find the potential challenges of the wood, such as anisotropic structure, heterogeneous complex structure, hydrophilia structure, fallible and perishable, and non-plastic process. The innovation in wood structure tells us we can obtain more detailed information from the disintegration and reconstructions of the wood from micro to nanoscales. For example, we can disintegrate cell wall into nanocellulose and cellulose chains. On the other hand, we can also modify the abundant trachytes in wood. Different wood functional structures determine the applications field. It is especially not that we can artificially manipulating nanoscale wood. Clasped crackers and the densified cell wall in wood can bring us satisfactory mechanical properties of all wood composites. In other end, in situ growth of a nano catalysis of around crackers in wood, yet rational catalytic channels with a controllable pathway. Moreover, we can also extract nanocells from cell wall, the world of the wood, probably without some important biochemicals from advanced applications. So, in my research group, we have carried out 3 parts of wood-derived biocomposites: optical nanopaper and flexible electronics and energy device. In fabrication of wood-derived composites, the size of fiber decides the property and application of the biocomposites. For example, decrease the fiber and pore size, we can get totally different properties of such optical transparency, mechanical strength, sound absorbing, thermal insulation. As we can see, porous wood is actually a natural sound absorber with continuous supports ranging from micro to nanoscale size. They can absorb a sound wave or reduce sound energy by vibrating air in wood pores, rendering a viscous resistance and also frictions and heat conductions between air and cell wall. However, we cannot find satisfactory sound absorbing properties of the original wood due to its kind porous struggles with high density. Then we interesting find that attractive sound absorbing properties when we integrate and reconstruct wood into a formed wood, manipulating with the continuous in 3D structure and much lower density of about 80 to 100 kilogram cubic meters. A density similar to foam EPS and glass fiber panels. We developed a clean water film process by self-designed steam injection technology by successfully large-scale production. The foam wood with density of 80 to 120 kilogram cubic meter has been developed. It presents an outstanding sound absorbing property and thermal insulation, especially in low sound footprints. Foam wood is expected to be used as noise reduction materials, thermal insulation, and lightweight sandwich materials in furniture and green buildings. By controllable manipulation of fibers disintegrate from wood, a sub or paper-based sound absorber was fabricated with a flexibility and no density. We have successfully applied it for a large scale, substituting the typical rubber noise barriers in air conditioners. It exhibits more noise reduction ability but no density and cost compared to the typical rubber noise barrier. It is noticed that all paper-based sound absorber is biodegradable, renewable, with easy producing process. In addition, the static and the dynamic import behavior was invested for the foam wood with perfect cautionary properties. The production of it has a low cost than common biodegradable foam package products. The composites are recycled at the end of the life and were built suitable for packaging small electronic products. As we can see, for a long time, indoor carcinogenic formaldehyde released from man-made wood boards. Tens of millions of children are reported to be suffered leukemia in old. Every scans fully developed a new wood board with nanobody technology by Wood Green Chemistry. It is not fabricated with a typical UF resin and a PF resin. For import, it can be used for popular wood process technology in a large-scale production process. We hope to bring it to market this year. As we can see, the typical glass is optional transparent, but the original wood and paper are optional non-transparent. The non-transparency is result from the difference in refraction index between air and the wood. For example, the more optional transparent paper are present by decreasing the size of cellulose fiber. By absorbing this macro or nano-sized cellulose fibers into a tight paper, the air impulse is most squeezed out, resulting uniform refraction index across the whole thickness. However, it can be subordinated. There is a conflict between the optical transparent and sound absorbing properties. Unfortunately, these two properties are still mutually exclusive. The price for both properties is perpetual in material studies in future. Nanoscale is widely considered to be an ideal material as a substrate for flexible electronics because it's a unique optional transparent struggle, remarkable electric process and extra low CTE as well as the excellent mechanical properties. We have prepared flexible nanopaper derived from temple oxided nanocellulose with Professor Huangbin from University of Maryland in USA. We report first the design of a flexible OLED device on the nanopaper, which was found to be stable in both the flat and the bent state. This experiment demonstrates that nanopaper is an extremely promising substrate for flexible electronics. Okay, and we had developed a low partial dissolution stringent to fabricate unit 4 cellulose nanofibers with a diameter of 5 to 10 nanometer from microscope cell cellulose fibers and promote separation of nanofibers in aqueous element by forming a water-soluble sodium carbide carbox methylcellulose through heterogeneous acetoxylation of cellulose. With obtained nanocellulose nanofiber, we fabricate nanopaper which exhibits high optical transparency of 19.5% with promising medical purposes. By directing deposing stiff nanowires on a weight nanofiber sheet, we fabricate a flexible, transparent electrode with 86.5% transparency and 26.2 ohm square sheet resistance. To avoid using toxins, we find a lot of clean energies for the fabrication of the nanowires, which were first used to enable the use of isopropyl alcohol washing, followed by disintegrating chemical modified fibers into dried nanometer-sized cellulose fiber powders. The cellulose powders were transferred into the nanocellulose with a diameter of 18 nanometer and length of several hundred nanometers. The fabricated nanopaper exhibit a higher optical transparency of 92% with a tensile strength of 107 MPa. This love plus methods for the nanoceres was no toxic eco-friendly by avoiding the blocking of the high pressure homogenization process. We demonstrate a rapid growth process to fabricate the transparent paper with regenerative cellulose fibers by employing a dissolving debonding stage. The regenerative cellulose fibers have an average diameter of 19.3 micro and length of several hundred micros and are prepared into transparent paper by a paper making method. This new dissolving debonding approach enables high production efficiency while green transparent paper with excellent optical and mechanical properties. The roll-to-roll fabrication of large roll optional transparent paper film is highly desirable for agriculture, in which the use of abundant of non-biodegradable plastic films in the past years brings several wide pollutions. The advantage of paper films includes transparency, health, thermal insulation, and cost, makes them ideal candidate materials for high import applications in various fields such as agriculture and packages. We had carried out for another scarcely large scale production for rapid optical dyeing bamboo paper. It has gained 35 million RMB sales value and 7 million RMB profits each year. Okay, to date, structural conductors have been fabricated, but the simulatorial realization of the transparency has structural ability, electronic conductive, self-healing, compatibility and sensibility through a simple, fast, cost-efficient approach to the scale challenge. Here, we report another new methods of using some natural small biologic molecule in humans and animals. It's used to fabricate transparent electronic conductive high strain up to 1,100 present and rehealable. Mechanical healing is efficiency of 86 present, and electronic healing service of 96 present. We also report a flexible and transparent scenes film heater composed of composite carbon fibers and regenerative cellulose. The use of regenerative is high transparency, strong adhesive. More importantly, it showed a rapid heating response about 12 seconds, high energy power testing, and a long-term stability of temperature. A new transparent and conductive woods were fabricated by using wood substrate, and low-cost conductive polymers were used as backfilling agents and in-situ polymerized in the denied wood, which endowed the materials with high transparency of about 90%, good structurality, and high electric conductive. As we can see, optical transparency and haze are inversely proportional, whereas in different paper, optical haze quantifies the percent of transmitted light that diffuses quartz, which is reflectable in solar-cell application. Optical haze is a property perfectly maximized in transparent substrates integrated into solar device. Other optoelectronic device require different levels of light scattering. Light scattering, for example, displays and touch screens need high, clear, and no optical haze. We demonstrate a lawful nanostruggled paper with very high transparency and high haze that was directly fabricated from original paper with a rapid ionic liquid polish process. The whole fabricate time only requires 10 minutes. Nanoscale transparent paper has high transparency of 91% and haze value of 89%. And it owns a known surface loveless. Provides good chance for printing nanometer-sized electronic components. I designed a roll-to-roll fabrication of flexible optical transparent nanopaper combined with electronic printing. Designed flexible transparent paper conductive substrate was used as the upper and lower electrodes of the solar cell. Then a water-soluble electronic ink was designed and deposited on the electronic surface as a buffer layer and other layer. Respectively, it shows that open calculus DC voltage of about 0.225 voltage after the same bending and the indoor indians LED light. The experimental results show that orange solar cells with multi level nanopaper struggle can work stable under bending conditions. Paper adopts single layer perfection plus perfacicati solar cells, similar to the open calculated voltage of about 1.0 there are two voltage and high short calculated short current with about 5.36% efficiency of device is achieved. This motivated us to investigate the applications in portable solar power generation and generation energy storage. Many thanks for my partners, students, colleges, and collaborators. Thank you. Thank you for attending my speech. Thank you very much.